everyone, welcome to Master to Teach step-by-step guide. In this video, we are going to learn how to check the use case diagram whether it's correct or not. I will try my best to explain step-by-step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Okay, let's start. Use case diagram. Simply, use case diagram shows a system or application, people or organization or other that interact with the system. It is a very high level diagram and typically it won't show a lot of details, but it's a great way to communicate complex idea in a fairly basic way. We have already learned what is use case diagram, different elements of use case diagram, how to draw use case diagram, what is high level use case description and how to write it, what is expanded use case description and how to write it including an alternative on it. Also, we have gone through the use case diagram example. If you haven't gone through the previous use case video tutorial, please find the link above or in the description below. From the previous tutorial, we have learned how to start drawing use case diagram. Now let's learn how to verify it in this tutorial. In use case diagram, only mention the functional requirement of the system. The functional requirement like check balance, transfer fund, make payment, etc. Check if there are any non-functional requirement in the use case or not. Non-functional requirement like speed of execution, memory consumption, user friendliness, etc. Use case is denoted by the oval shape. While drawing in the paper, make sure to write the use case name before drawing an oval shape because the size of the oval shape may not sufficient for the use case name. And also make a list of use cases and its respective actors before drawing the use case diagram. The use case name is usually an active verb and a noun phrase. For example, check balance, transfer fund, make payments, display an error message, verify login details, etc. Check the use case names properly whether it's an active verb and a noun phrase or not. Also, make sure the name of the use case is meaningful. All the use cases should be inside the system, which is represented by a rectangle box, so that only at the end of design, system box should be closed if you are drawing use case diagram in paper. Check whether all the use cases are inside the system box or not. It's good practice to put the use case in a logical order where possible, like login, then book service, after that make payment, because users will call these use cases on serial wise and easy to understand the flow of the system. Check the use cases are in logical order or not. Try to maintain the use cases in half circle shapes like this, which will look more clear and attractive. Try to maintain the position of use cases in proper shapes inside the system box so that no need to overlap the lines while drawing the relationship between the actor and the use cases. Check if there is any overlap and can be fixed by repositioning the use cases or actors. In use case diagram, try to include at least one include relationship, like login and verify login use case. The included use case is a use case which is automatically called from the system whenever the base use case is executed. Here, login is the base use case, whereas verify login is included use case. Make sure that included use cases are called automatically by the system so that there doesn't exist any relationship with the actors. Do not draw a line between the actor and the included use case. Check whether there is a line between the actor and the included use case or not. If there is a similar use case that is also accessible by the actor, for example, transfer fund use case has include relationship with the check balance use case. Here, whenever the actor calls the transfer fund use case, the check balance use case is automatically called by the system internally. But there is also a requirement that the user can check balance as well. In this scenario, make a different use case like check user balance where actor and the use case check user balance relationship exist. Don't mention the minor functionality use case as include relationship use case, which may lead the diagram mess. The simpler your diagram, the better. When producing a use case model, always keep in mind what you are trying to portray and for what purpose. The include relationship is shown by the dotted line with arrow, and arrow must point to the included use case from the base use case and add a label include like this. Check whether include relationship arrow pointed to included use case or not and is arrow labeled with include or not. Similarly, include at least one extend relationship in the use case diagram like login and display error message. Extended use case may or may not call when the base use case is executed. Here, login is a base use case whereas the display error message is an extended use case. Same as in include relationship, the extended use case is called automatically by the system if the condition matches, so that there doesn't exist any relationship with the actor. So make sure there doesn't exist any line between the actor and the extended use case. Check whether there is a line between the actor and the extended use case or not. The extend relationship is shown by the dotted line with arrow similar to the include relationship, but the arrow must point to the base use case from the extended use case, which is just opposite of include relationship, and add a label extend like this. Check whether extend relationship arrow pointed to base use case or not, and is arrow labeled with extend or not. Also, more than one use case can extend the same extended use case only if the function needs to execute for both use cases are the same. Otherwise, make a different extended use case for each. For example, the login base use case extends the display error message use case, and also the payment use case also extends display error message. Here, different use case extends different use cases. So, separate the extended use case like display login error and display payment error. Check whether more than one base use cases extends or includes the same extended or included use case carefully. Make sure to include at least one generalization in the use case diagram. Generalization is also known as inheritance. Generalization is showing the relationship between the parents and the child use case relationship. In simple words, generalization is showing the type of actor or use case in the system. For the generalization relationship, draw a solid line with an arrow from the child use case or actor to parent use case or actor. Make sure there doesn't exist any label in the arrow. For example, the system has new customer as well as old customer, which can be shown in generalization like this. Let's see another example of generalization of use cases. Payment use case. The system has a different method of payment like PayPal, MasterCard, Visa card, which can be shown in generalization as this. Check whether the use case diagram contains any generalization or not. Best to show the generalization in actor as well as in use case. Check whether the arrow is solid line with an arrow pointing towards parent actors or parent use case or not. Also confirm that it doesn't exist label in arrow. There is one another type of notation which is extension point. Extension point are just a detailed version of extended relationship. And also can be shown in note what sort of condition would lead to these extension points. If possible, so at least one extension point in the use case diagram. The actor is representing by the human stick image. Anyone who used to perform a certain functions in a system is actor. Actor may be someone or something that can be a person, an organization, another system, machine, or any external device. So who or what is going to use our system in is a actor, like customer, staff, admin, bank, student, teacher, etc. Make sure to represent all actors with a human stick image, even for the machine, external devices, and also contain at least more than one actor in the use case diagram. There are two types of actors, primary actor and the secondary actors. A primary actor initiates the use of the system, while the secondary actor is more reactionary. In other simple words, primary actor requests something to the system and the secondary actor responds to the primary actor. Primary actors should be positioned in the left of the system, whereas secondary actors are placed on the right side of the system. Check whether primary actors are shown in the left side or not. Similarly, secondary actors are on the right side or not. For detail, please go through my previous video tutorial where you can find step-by-step process with details on use case diagram. Now let's move forward. If there is any automatic job doing use case in the application, like if customer didn't use their ATM card for more than 3 months, system will send an alert message to the customer. In this kinds of automatic job use case, actor as system is represented with humanistic image and so relationship with the use cases. Check if there is any automatic job doing use cases in the system or not. Moving forward, system. The project that you are developing is a system. The system is representing a rectangle shape where the system name is written inside the top of the system. The rectangle shape helps to define the overall scope of the system that you are going to develop, so that everything that the system does jobs place inside the system, whereas anything outside the rectangle doesn't happens in the system. Make sure there is only one rectangle box representing as a system where all the use cases are included inside the box and actors are outside of the box. Check whether you have written the system name inside the box at the top or not. While drawing use case diagram in a paper, make sure you have left good margin in left side and right side of the box, cause you have to draw actors over there and close the system or box at the end after drawing use case diagram, cause we are unknown about how much space do the use case will cover. Note that even complex systems should be restricted to a simplistic visualization of functionality, behavior, and relationships. So try to make a simple, clear, meaningful design. Here are the list of checklists which you need to check once more. Check if there are any non-functional requirements in the use cases. Check the use case name properly, whether it's an active verb and a noun phrase or not. Check whether all the use cases are inside the system box or not. Check the use case are in the logical order or not. Check if there is any overlap and can be fixed by repositioning the use cases or actors. Check whether the use case diagram contain at least one include relationship or not. Check whether there is a line between the actor and the included use case or not. Check whether include relationship arrow pointed to the included use case or not, and is arrow labeled with include or not. Check whether the use case diagram contains at least one extend relationship or not. Check whether there is a line between the actor and the extended use case or not. Check whether extend relationship arrow pointed to base use case or not, and is arrow labeled with extend or not. Check whether more than one base use case extends or includes the same extended or included use case carefully. Check whether the use case diagram contains any generalization or not. Check whether the arrow is solely lined with an arrow pointing towards parent's actor or parent's use case or not. Also, confirm that there doesn't exist the label in arrow. If possible, show at least one extension point in the use case diagram. Make sure to represent all actors with humanistic image, even for the machine, external devices, and also contains at least more than one actor in the use case diagram. Check whether primary actors are shown in the left side or not. Similarly, secondary actors are on the right side or not. Check if there is any automatic job doing use case in the system or not. Make sure there is only one rectangle box representing as a system where there all the use cases are included inside the box and actors are outside of the box or not. Check whether you have written the system name inside the box at the top or not. I hope you learned from this video tutorial. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website mastertoteach.com. and we will see you again soon. Bye.